technique that I am about to show you works for most types of text-based data, including CSV and TXT. We are using the demo datasets provided by IBM in the English Samples folder. There is no CSV version of the demo data, but there is a text version. Choose File, Import Data, Text Data. We will open demo.txt, but we could use these same steps to open DAT files, CSV, or tabbed limited formats. Basically, it's hard to go wrong by using the text data import for any type of text file. Click Open. This will open the text import wizard. You can select a predefined format or create a new format in the wizard. Leave it set to No and click Continue. Select Delimited to indicate that the file has a delimited formatting structure. Select Yes to indicate that the file includes variable names at the top. The decimal symbol for our numbers is a period. The delimiter in this file is a tab. It is important that we know that, especially if we have commas in the numbers of our data instead of periods as decimals, or if we had extra spaces. So click Continue. Enter 2 for the line number where the first case of data begins, because the variable names are on the first row. Each line or row is a case. We want to import all cases. Therefore, these settings can be kept at their default. Click Continue. Here is where we really begin to see what our data are going to look like. You see that the default delimiters are tab and space. Now you may wonder what to do because I did not show you the original data set. But don't worry, just look at how the data are going to import. Unclick the tab delimiter. It got worse, didn't it? So re-click it. Click on comma. Nothing changed. So unclick it. Now notice all of these empty cells. Now, under gender, we have M and F, but we also have an F over here and an M over here. This is a mess. But remember that we had some leading spaces with variables. Let's remove those leading spaces. Ah, that is much better. But look out here on the right, we still have more empty cells and words that do not match with numbers. What is happening here is that SPSS is still using spaces as a delimiter. So the space between the words income category is creating an extra column. To fix this, unclick space as a delimiter. Feel free to click on other options and see what they do. Your goal here is to keep clicking until your data are rectangular and look correct. When they do, click Continue. We get a warning that SPSS has changed the invalid variable names, such as income category, and that's good. So click OK. In this next window, you can edit variable names, define data types, or make other changes. In the data preview, select Income. Select Dollar from the Data Format drop-down list. The variable marital status contains both string and numeric values. Fortunately for us, fewer than 5% of the values are words or periods. Leave the default setting of 95% for percentage of values that determine the automatic data format. This variable will be treated as numeric, and any string values will be set to system missing. So click Continue. Leave the default selections in the last step. Click Done to import the data. In the output window, you will find all of the syntax for what we have just done. You could include this with a copy of your original raw data to make your research more replicable. In other words, anyone else could run your syntax on your raw data and replicate exactly the same output that you did.